गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल सॉल्व फ्यू ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ चैप्टर 4 स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द एटम। नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 ऑफ पेज नंबर 47। इफ एन एटम कंटेन्स 1 इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड 1 प्रोटोन, विल इट कैरी एनी चार्ज और नॉट? नो, इट विल नॉट कैरी एनी चार्ज ऑन इट। व्हाई? बिकॉज इट हैज 1 इलेक्ट्रॉन। One electron has negative charge, 1, that is minus 1, and one proton which has positive charge, 1. So this atom has one electron having negative charge, 1, minus 1, and one proton having positive charge, 1, plus 1. Then both will cancel each other, nullify each other. As a result, net charge on the atom is 0. So this atom is electrically neutral, having no charge on it. Now, question number 2 of page number 49. Helium atom has an atomic mass of 4U and 2 protons in its nucleus. How many neutrons does it have? See, what is given? Atomic mass of 4U. Atomic mass or mass number, both are same thing, is equal to the sum of number of protons and number of neutrons. So I can write atomic mass or mass number is equal to number of protons plus number of neutrons. Atomic mass or mass number is denoted with A. Is equal to number of protons plus number of neutrons. Now, atomic mass or mass number that is denoted with A is given 4U is equal to number of protons 2 plus number of neutrons we have to find out. 2, we will transfer it from right to left side, it will be in minus. So number of neutrons is equal to 4 minus 2, that is 2. So what is the total number of neutrons in this helium atom? That is 2. Okay, question number 1 of page number 50. Write the distribution of electrons, means electronic distribution or electronic configuration of carbon and sodium atoms. Okay, now we have to write the distribution of electrons, means electronic distribution, or we can say electronic configuration of carbon and sodium atom. Okay, it means we have to write down the distribution of electrons in various shells of carbon and sodium atom. Now carbon atom has total 6 electrons. So, in its K shell, there will be 2 electrons. Now, out of 6, 2 electrons are accommodated in first shell, K shell. Now, how many electrons are remaining? 4. That will be accommodated in L shell. Okay, so 2 plus 4, total 6 electrons. So, in this way, electrons are distributed in various shells of a carbon atom. It is K2L4, or we can also say that 2-4 in K L shell respectively. Okay, now diagrammatically we also represent this electronic configuration. How is that? First of all, make nucleus of carbon atom, which is at the center inside of the carbon atom. Then there are two shells, K and L. So this is K shell, this is L shell. K shell is having 2 electrons. So I am representing these 2 electrons with 2 dots. L shell has 4 electrons. So I will represent these 4 electrons with 4 dots in L shell. So in this way, we can write down the electronic configuration of carbon atom, that is 2-4 in K and L shell respectively. In addition to this, we can represent this electronic distribution or configuration diagrammatically, and here is the diagram. Now, sodium atom has total 11 electrons. So in its K shell, there will be 2 electrons. Then how many electrons are remaining? 9. In L shell, maximum 8 electrons can be accommodated. So here 8. Now 2 plus 8, 10. So out of 11 electrons, 10 electrons are already accommodated in K and L shells. Now only 1 electron is remaining, that will accommodate in M shell. So its electronic configuration is K2L8M1. We can also say that 281 in K, L, M shells respectively. Okay, now diagrammatically we can represent it. First of all, make nucleus of sodium atom. Then there are 3 shells in sodium atom, KLM. K has 2 electrons, so 2 dots. L has 8 electrons, so make 8 electrons, 8 dots. Then M has only 1 electron, then 1 dot. Okay, so in K shell 2 electrons, in L shell 8 electrons, and in M shell 1 electron. So in this way electrons are distributed in KLM shells, 281. Okay, we have written electronic configuration and we have also represented this electronic configuration with the help of diagram. In both the cases, in carbon atom and sodium atom, we have followed all the rules given by Bohr and Bury. Okay, first of all, we apply the formula 2n square to calculate what is the maximum number of electrons that can be accommodated in a given shell. According to that formula, in K shell, maximum 2 electrons can be accommodated. So maximum 2 electrons are accommodated here of first shell, K shell, in carbon and in sodium atom. Then remaining electrons will go in next shell, that is second shell, L shell. Okay, L shell has the maximum capacity of 8 electrons. That is why here maximum 8 electrons are accommodated in L shell. And here only 4 are remaining, so that 4 are accommodated in L shell. Its electronic configuration is complete. Here 1 is remaining, that goes in last shell, that is M shell. Okay, so in this way we have followed Bohr-Bury's rule while writing electronic configuration of these atoms. Question number 2 of page number 50. If K and L shells of an atom are full, then what would be the total number of electrons in the atom? See, as I told you, the Bohr-Bury's rule regarding electronic configuration of an atom. The very first rule given by Bohr and Bury for electronic configuration or for electronic distribution of an atom, that is, we have to apply the formula 2n square to find out the maximum number of electrons that can be accommodated in a given shell. And according to that formula, what is the maximum capacity of K shell? 2. Okay. And what is the maximum capacity of L shell? That is 8. Okay. Now, in the question, it is given that K and L shells of an atom are full. It means there is an atom having K and L shell which are completely filled. And just now I told you how many maximum electrons can be accommodated in K or L shell. How many electrons fill them completely? That is 2 and 8. So if it is given that in an atom there are 2 shells, K and L, and they are completely full, it means they have their maximum number of electrons by which they are completely filled, that is 2 and 8 electrons. So what is the total number of electrons in this atom? 2 plus 8, that is 10 electrons. Okay, so the answer of this question is 10 electrons. Now page number 52, question number 1. How will you find the valency of chlorine, sulfur, magnesium? First of all, we will talk about chlorine. Atomic number of chlorine is 17. So it has number of electrons 17. So its electronic configuration is in K shell 2, in L shell 8, in M shell 7. So its electronic configuration is 2, 8, 7 in K, L, M shells respectively. So its outermost shell is M, having 7 electrons. Okay. Now, in order to complete its octet for stability, it gains 1 electron. Now, its outermost shell, then its outermost shell M will have 7 plus 1, 8 electrons. In this way, it will have complete octet and will gain stability ultimately. So, how many electrons does chlorine atom take or gain? It is 1 electron. So, its valency is 1. As I already told you, valency is the number of electrons donated, accepted or shared by an atom. So here, chlorine atom accepts or gains or takes 1 electron in order to have complete octet for stability. So its valency is 1. Okay, then sulfur. Atomic number of sulfur is 16, so it has number of electrons 16. That thing I also told you in previous class. Atomic number is the number of electrons or number of protons. Okay, so sulfur atom has atomic number 16. It means it has 16 electrons as well as 16 protons. Okay. So, it has 16 electrons, so its electronic configuration will be in K shell 2, in L shell 8, in M shell 6, 2, 8, 6, total 16, in K, L, M shells respectively. Now, outermost shell is M, having 6 electrons. So, in order to have complete octet for stability, it takes 2 electrons. Then it will have 6 plus 2, 8 electrons in its outermost shell. In this way, it will acquire complete octet, which will result in its stability. How many electrons does sulfur atom take in order to have complete octet for stability? 2 electrons. So valency is 2. Of sulfur. Now, magnesium. Magnesium has atomic number 12. So, it has number of electrons 12. That is why it has electronic configuration in K shell 2, in L shell 8, in M shell 2. 2, 8, 2, total 12 in K, L, M shells respectively. So its outermost shell is M, having 2 electrons, which it donates. Then in its outermost shell, M will have no electron, so it will be removed. And after that, L will be its outermost shell, having 8 electrons. In this way, magnesium atom acquires octet by donating 2 electrons. So, how many electrons does magnesium atom donate, lose or give? That is 2. So, its valency is 2. Because magnesium donates its 2 electrons to other atom for acquiring octet in order to have stability. Okay, so this is question number 1. Now page number 52, question number 1 of second column. If number of electrons in an atom is 8 and number of protons is also 8, then what is the atomic number of the atom and what is the charge on the atom? It is a very simple question. See, we have to find the atomic number of the atom. Atomic number is also denoted with Z, is equal to the number of electrons or protons. Why? Because already I told you, in an atom, number of electrons is equal to the number of protons. Means magnitude of negative charges is equal to the magnitude of positive charges. That is why they cancel, nullify each other, and the net charge on the atom is zero. So an atom is electrically neutral. This thing we have studied so many times. Here also, atomic number, which is denoted with Z, is equal to either number of electrons or number of protons. So we can take any number. We can take the number of electrons or number of protons, because both are same in an atom. Okay, that will be equal to the atomic number denoted with Z. Here in this question, there is an atom having number of electrons 8. So it obvious that it will have number of protons also 8, and it is given also 8. Okay, so atomic number Z is equal to number of electrons or protons, that is 8 or 8. So atomic number is 8. Okay, now what is the charge on the atom? See, there are total 8 electrons having minus 8 charge, plus 8 protons having plus 8 charge. So minus 8 plus 8, both will cancel, nullify each other. So the net charge on the atom is 0, and atom is electrically neutral, having no charge or zero charge. Now question number 2. With the help of a table 4.1, it is given in your textbook, you can take the help of this table. Find out the mass number of oxygen and sulfur atoms. See, mass number or atomic mass, both are same thing, denoted with A, is equal to number of protons plus number of neutrons. This thing I already told you, that mass number or atomic mass denoted with capital A is equal to the number of protons plus number of neutrons, means it is equal to the sum of protons and neutrons. Okay, now we have to find out the mass number, means value of A, for oxygen atom. So we have to add the number of protons and number of neutrons present in oxygen atom. Okay, which is given in the table 4.1, that is 8 plus 8, so it is 16 U. So what is the mass number or atomic mass A of oxygen atom? It is equal to number of protons in oxygen atom, that is 8, plus number of neutrons in oxygen atom, that is also 8. 8 plus 8, 16 U. Remember one point. Here you can see number of protons and number of neutrons are equal in oxygen atom. In an atom, number of protons may be equal to or can be equal to number of neutrons. But this is not so in every case. In few of the atoms, number of protons is equal to the number of neutrons, but it is not equal in every case. In many of the cases, number of protons is not equal to the number of neutrons. For example, in sodium atom, there are total 11 protons, but neutrons are 12. So number of protons are not necessarily equal or same to that of the neutrons. In some of the cases it can be equal, but in many of the cases they are not equal. but number of electrons is always equal to number of protons. Now mass number or atomic mass or A is equal to number of protons in sulfur atom, that is 16, plus number of neutrons in sulfur atom, that is also 16. 16 plus 16, 32 U. So this is the mass number or atomic mass or value of A for sulfur atom. It is equal to number of protons in sulfur atom, that is 16, plus number of neutrons in sulfur atom, that is also 16. 16 plus 16, 32 U. Now question number 1 of page number 53. For the symbol H, D and T, tabulate 3 subatomic particles found in each of them. Here H stands for first isotope of hydrogen, that is protium, denoted with H11. D stands for second isotope of hydrogen, deuterium, denoted with H21. Then T stands for third isotope of hydrogen, that is tritium, denoted with H31. So you can see these are the three isotopes of hydrogen having same atomic number 111 but different mass numbers 1, 2, 3. Okay, we have to tabulate the number of subatomic particles, means electrons, protons, neutrons present in them. So we have to represent the number of electrons, protons and neutrons present in three isotopes of hydrogen in a tabular form. First of all, we will talk about number of electrons. See, all the three isotopes of hydrogen having same atomic number 111, atomic number is equal to the number of electrons or number of protons. So if atomic number is 111, then number of electron present in them is obviously 111. Okay, then number of protons, atomic number is equal to the number of electrons or number of protons. So if atomic number is 1, then number of electron is 111, as well as number of proton is also 111. And mass number is different in all the three isotopes, that is 1, 2, 3. It means their neutrons also differ. How's that? That I already told you in previous class. See, first of all, protium having mass number 1, mass number is denoted with A, is equal to number of protons plus number of neutrons. In a protium, in first isotope H11, mass number is 1, so A is 1. Number of protons, we have written 1, plus number of neutrons, we have to find out. 1, it will be transferred from right to left, it will be in minus. So number of neutrons is equal to 1 minus 1, that is 0. So what is the number of neutron present in protium H11? That is 0. Now if we talk about deuterium H21, its mass number, means A's value is 2, is equal to number of proton 1, plus number of neutron we have to find out. 1 will be transferred from right to left, then it will be in minus, so number of neutron is equal to 2 minus 1, 1. So number of neutron present in deuterium, it is 1. Now it's time for tritium. Tritium H31, so its mass number, which is denoted with A, is 3, is equal to number of protons 1, plus number of neutrons we have to find out. 1 will be transferred from right to left, it will be in minus. So number of neutron is equal to 3 minus 1, that is 2. So number of neutron is 2. So we have tabulated number of three subatomic particles present in three isotopes of hydrogen. So you can see in the table all the three isotopes of hydrogen named as protium, deuterium, tritium have same number of electrons 111, have same number of protons 111, that is why they have same atomic number. Okay, and number of neutrons vary and differ in three isotopes of hydrogen, that is 0, 1, 2. That is why they have different mass number. Okay, now question number 2. Write the electronic configuration of any pair of isotopes and isobars. So we have to take any pair of isotopes. We will take pair of isotopes of carbon. As I told you, in nature there are two types of carbon atom found having same atomic number 6 6, but different mass number 12 14. Okay, first of all I am going to write the electronic configuration of first isotope of carbon, which is denoted with C 12 6. C, its atomic number is 6, so it has number of electrons 6, so its electronic configuration in K shell 2, in L shell 4, 2 plus 4, 6 electrons in K and L shell respectively. Okay, now second isotope of carbon having mass number 14, atomic number 6, it also has same atomic number 6, so number of electrons is same 6, so it has same electronic configuration in K shell 2, in L shell 4, 2 plus 4, 6 electrons in K and L shell respectively. So you can see on the board that both the isotopes of carbon element have same atomic number 6, 6. That is why they have same number of electrons 6, 6. That is why they have same electronic configuration 2, 4, 2, 4 in K and L shells respectively. There is no role of different mass number in the electronic configuration. Okay, now isobars. Okay, now we will take a pair of isobars that I already told you in previous class, argon and calcium. These are the two atoms of different elements, argon and calcium, having different atomic number 18 and 20, but same mass number 40, 40. That is why they are called isobars. Argon has atomic number 18, so it has number of electrons 18, so its electronic configuration in K shell 2, in L shell 8, in M shell 8, 2, 8, 8, total 18 electrons in K, L, M shells respectively. Okay, now calcium, total 20 electrons. Why? Because it has atomic number 20, so total number of electrons 20, having electronic configuration K shell 2, L shell 8, M shell 8 and N shell 2. Total, just make a total of it, 2, 8, 8, 2, it is 20 in K, L, M, N shells respectively. So argon, which is having atomic number 18, that is why it has 18 electrons, having electronic configuration 2, 8, 8 in K, L, M shells respectively. And calcium having atomic number 20, so it has 20 electrons in total, which has an electronic configuration 2, 8, 8, 2 in K, L, M, N shells respectively. So pair of isobars have different electronic configuration. Why? Because they have different number of electrons as they have different atomic number. Here also same mass number will not play any role in electronic configuration. This is all for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.